harmony to balance. Old standby topic, but I want to add a little more advanced level with it. So harmony to balance. I've got two different styles of looking at things. One is sort of a center to circle style. The other is upper half, lower half. The idea of things, the functionality or the actual energy experience of things. So use those two as sort of a reference, maybe. Okay. I would think, just bullshitting for a bit, that if I'm not in accord with myself, or if I'm not in harmony with myself, it's going to be hard to be in harmony with anybody or anything else. If I'm out of sorts, I'm going to be out of sorts. Okay. We're just to start the conversation. Any comments on harmony? Help.
Sensei, this is Justin. My sense of harmony involves a give and a take, a partnership of beings, forces, etc. And there's a give and a take involved here.
Okay. Now he's talking about his person and the other person and using that as a reference. Okay. Fine. No problem. But we also have just personal, you alone harmony. You with your own two forces in whatever form is comfortable, natural, the types of forces you may choose. For example, there could be an inhale exhale beat, and you like to use that. And as you continue and settle and open with that, is more harmony between the in and out. Okay. Brings us to a point of balance. Okay. Somebody else may like movement. Okay. I turn to the left and then I turn to the right. And after a bit, there's more harmony. The left and right turns start to sort of equalize each other. Okay. And that brings us to a point of balance. So what should we call that? The personal form of harmony at first? I don't know. All right. Blah, blah, blah. Somebody, harmony. What's harmony mean for you? What's your sense?
Sensei, TJ here.
TJ there.
All right. Of course, harmony has a whole different sense for me as a musician. It is the alignment or the relationship of notes and the way that expresses in a melody more than just a single note. It has depth, it has dimension, it has qualities of beauty, those sorts of things. Okay. But harmony, I'm interested to take a step back from where Justin started, which is a great place to start, but interested in why you would say harmony to balance and not balance to harmony. And perhaps if you said something about that, that could clarify a little bit more about what harmony is in the way okay. that you're talking about it.
All right. Mm-hmm. OSensei told me that the harmony part is the movement forces, those forces that are in the two beat of things, the great yin and the great yang, the great he, the great she, the great idea, the great functionality, whatever, the movement. And when there's any accord at whatever level of harmony between your choice of the style of movement you want to use, that he called that balance. So I'm just bouncing off of his words, okay? But he did say harmony is the moving part, the things that move, if that means anything to you.
Yeah, it means a lot.
Oh, good.
It kind of speaks to the way things move and develop. So if I'm using a musical sense of vibration, frequency, that sort of thing, and look for harmony, it's not just in a single place. It is a development that takes place. And so now I understand a little bit more about why you say harmony to balance, and not the other way around. Not that it can't be the other way around, but, you know, yeah.
Well, Sensei, if this is Lauren, and if I could just jump in.
Yeah.
I've been, you've often done practices on the mat, Sensei, of, you know, left, right, you know, lift your right hand, lift your left hand. Eventually they become more equal or balanced, yeah. You know, or up, down, you know, and I tend to find that it goes from balance myself to harmony. Rather than, and maybe it doesn't really matter.
Whatever you guys want to do, I'm just telling you. I'm just telling you what OSensei told me. Okay.
But I wanted to add.
Whatever.
Dija talked about harmony in music, but what I also wanted to say is that harmony seems dynamic. It's not static. In other words,
It's moving.
It's always changing and adjusting.
Yeah.
And so it's. It's the sense that it's not fixed. It's not static. You don't achieve it and then it's like locked.
Remember, people, we're in dimensionality. And as soon as Bobby is comfortable, then boom, activity starts and it's trying to be a Robert. And as soon as Robert's comfortable, boom, there's a lot of la la la. And if I hang out there properly, there's a Nadeau, and again, a sensei, and again, a whatever, whatever. It's moving because it's dimensionality.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, of course.
So, sensei, there's dimensionality in that aspect of harmony that you're talking about now. There's also, to kind of pick up a little bit on what Lauren was saying, that harmony is not static. You're talking about harmony being moving, but balance is the same way, isn't it? Because I mean, that's my experience, that balance is not a fixed state, you know. Only when we use the teeter-totter thing and it's exactly in the middle and stopped there for a moment. So but as a movement, I think you said something about OSensei talking about people asking, or someone, maybe you or someone asked him, do you ever lose your balance? And he said, yes, but I recover it so fast you don't see.
I don't know if that was my story or somebody else's. I'm blank.
Yeah, me too. I don't remember the source of that, but it makes sense that when there is the qualities of harmony present in its multidimensional possibilities, that moving in and out of balance is possible, even in the fluctuations.
Yeah, because situation will change, the balance will change.
Yeah, that's beautifully said. Well said.
And it's changing pretty frequently, right?
All the time, as far as I can tell. Thank you for that.
Yeah. Anyway, how we're going to up it tonight, this, because we've been talking about harmony and balance and whatever, for these many years, okay? What I wanted to bring it cross, clarify, add on, is the how to utilize this game of using my terminology, harmony to a point of balance where both those forces feel like they're okay with each other. And maybe we'll do some old simple exercises in a moment. Okay. And at that point of balance, bear with me on my words. Okay. Oftentimes, we're happy to be better balanced. And we say, oh, there, I feel better. I'm not at odds with myself right now. I feel better. I'm okay with myself. And we stop there because it's better than not being okay with yourself, which you were an hour or day before. Right? But I want to say at that balance point, let's also call that a doorway, an opening, a what's the other word, Bob? What's the other word I use there? Doorway?
Portal.
Portal. Okay, portal. That it's a portal to the next underlying dimension. Okay? Oftentimes we get balanced. And because it's better than being unbalanced, we say, oh, great, leave me alone. And I'm saying, well, if you have a little more time, let's trade it in for the underlying level and experience that level. Let's use the balance as a doorway, portal, introduction, lead in to the next dimension. Okay. Yes. And I think I've never quite said it as clearly in the past as I'm trying to say it now. Okay. Is Ross Madden on tonight? No. Ross, if you're on, say
he is not present.
Okay. I wanted to mention. Okay. I'm going to talk about Ross behind his back. Some sessions back, we were playing with something, probably some kind of harmonious vibe. We got to a better level. And I said, okay, who are you? And Ross said, oh, this is nice. This harmony is nice. And I said, okay, who are you? He said, I'm a nice guy. And then I pushed on him a bit. I said, now who are you? And he continued, I'm a nice guy. Okay, so that was the balance of the level of harmony he got to with whatever practice we were doing. And what I would say now to him is, be prepared. If you have the time and the energy, be prepared, or the desire for more. Okay, the time, the energy, or the desire for more, be prepared to trade that in for the next underlying finer dimension of beingness. Okay, whatever precedes nice guy. So nice guy is great, point of balance. Okay, he was aware he was experiencing nice. Good, beautiful balance point, beautiful doorway, beautiful portal. Now, zoom, inner finer, the next level. Experience the aliveness, could I say, of the next level. And then, for example, the character. Who are you at this level? And you're going to be somehow superior to the nice guy, whatever that means. Are you following what I'm trying to say? Yeah? Okay. So, there's a tendency with humans. Let's say you've been nervous and you do a little practice and you're calm. Thank God I'm calm. There's a tendency for the humans to stop there. Okay. One reason might be they don't want to gamble that there's something more because they don't want to lose the calmness. So for whatever reason, people tend to hit a certain level and hang on to it for dear life. Okay. So to have a sense there's more, how the more works, to have a desire for more, a pull for more, whatever the right words are there. Okay. To continue. All right. Anybody want to bounce back on anything there?
It's Justin again. I think one thing that keeps us humans from growing is the experience of comfortableness. We reach a level of comfortable. And like you're saying, that's for all intents and purposes, good enough. And we may linger there for a long, long time and really not grow that much at that point.
Yeah, it especially shows in an astral plane where the harmony hum gets finer and finer. And whoa, this is very nice. At those levels, there's a tendency, I call it hammock space, for them to go into a hammock space. They got it made. There's no body pain. There's no work to be done per se. Okay. So they just hang out at that level when there's so much more. So much more. Yeah. Here in the human world, there's a possibility that you'll get bumped, you know. So whatever you're saying, Justin, a certain level, and say, hey, this is great, you're great. But then your grandchild gets sick with an incurable disease, and that throws you. Or all of your investments turned out bad, and you lose all your money, and that throws you. So it's possible in the human condition for something to break the bank there. Or if you luck out, in a human way of looking at things, you have enough money to sustain you through retirement, or nobody in your family gets sick, nobody dies, nothing bad happens. In the human condition, that's not so there, but anyway, somebody, where the hell are we here?
Sensei Tija again.
Okay.
You and I have talked about this, and we've talked about it generally, but as a meditation teacher and so-called mindfulness teacher, many people are drawn to different kinds of practices.
Yes. Yes.
So they are drawn, let's say, to meditation or to mindfulness because they hear, you can calm your anxiety and just become a calmer, more centered person. Yeah. And all those, the claims are true because the if one sincerely does the practices in the right way with the correct guidance and so on, you can connect with the domain of calmness. And a lot of people will just stick there. I think you said that earlier in your reference. Mm-hmm. They'll stick there because they're not willing to give up. What if I go beyond that in my meditation practice, will I lose my calmness? Will I lose that sense of centeredness? So I just wanted to bring that up because that's another aspect in working with meditation. Same as in any art, Aikido or any of the other, any art whatsoever.
Yeah.
Here you go.
So the different forms, what are they? Hang on a second.
They could be artistic forms, of course. And there's also, you know, our person who came on leadership. Once you gain a certain quality, you might want to stop there because in order to go to the next so-called level, you kind of, in some ways, you have to let go of.
Yes.
You have to let go of what you've already attained, you know. Yeah.
And if you have an audience.
Yes.
And you're comfortable, whatever. And you're trading in for the next, you let go of that. You don't know at first if you're going to have an audience when you come back from your inner retreat, could I call it?
Sure, of course.
Yeah.
I think it's a good
word. You don't know what you're going to say yet. You don't know how you're going to present yet. You don't know if anybody's going to be there. So you hang on to your group at that level. So, by the way, that is one thing that can hold teachers back.
Yeah.
Yeah. They get stuck
sure,
with the level of their students, which is yes, work with your students at their level, but you continue to develop. But a lot of them don't, because they don't want to lose that, what they got, their group. Yeah.
I got to practice just in order to keep up with my students. So
well, that's good.
And of course, and continue my for my own development. If I wasn't interested in meditation or Aikido or any of the arts that I'm interested in, it wouldn't be authentic. You know, I wouldn't be a genuine teacher. Yeah. We've talked about this also in terms of Aikido. The folks will get to a certain degree, like Nidan or Sandan or something like that. I can remember from my own experience with you. You said, you know, I was asking what I needed to do for the next level. And you said, continue to open, to let go and open. And I said, yes, but what should I do? You said, continue to let go and open. So it's hard because you have to let go of the things that you already know in order to really genuinely move into a more, to a deeper, finer, greater capacity level.
Yeah. And it's, again, people, it's scary to people. Mm. Yeah. Until you begin to catch the trick of how it works, then you sort of don't mind letting go for the next and don't mind letting go for the next, because it's, we've tried to show that in our earlier classes. That one level, certain something, next level, a bit better, easy, next level. Oh, that's even nicer. I said, that's it. That's it. You got the pattern. It doesn't change. But they don't know that. Or if they're on their journey, enter a much finer, I don't know, call it involved, with more things showing, that they misunderstand, instead of, no, this is a level, easy, let it unfold until you're comfortable there, actually. Anyway, so it's a typical people thing to this that we're talking about, to be afraid of letting go of what you got for the next.
Exactly, and learning how to trust the universe, yeah. And trust the process of unfolding.
Yeah,
you have that essential trust, you're going to be grabbing on, whether that's meditation practice, whether that's music or Aikido, and any art, you know, Justin's wonderful medical practice and so on. He continues, I can tell just listening to him every time, you know, he's deepening in his practice. And
oh, you can feel it. Yeah.
Yeah, I can feel it.
Yeah, you can feel that he's been.
He's right. Doing the work.
So again, just to go over again, that there are different things that you like that assist you in this harmony game. Okay, so we've got breathing throughout, chanting, certain body movements, meditating, yeah. So anything vibrational, chanting, vibrational, anything vibrational. OSensei like fire and water as an example. As the fire and water at whatever level, as they get more in harmony with each other, there is steam. So he like fire, water, steam, okay? And because of my background, I've always liked fire, water, steam. Okay. A little bit esoteric for some people, fire, water, steam, what the hell? It just represents two forces. And the harmony between them is represented by the steam. At a steam level, there we are. Now we've got us a doorway. Yeah. See, when I was first playing with steam, fire, water, steam, and I'd get to the steam, I'd just hang out with the steam. I wasn't sharp enough at that time to go, okay, steam, steam. And you fully experience steam, steam, but with the sense of, now this is an opening to the next. This is a trade-in of everything to the next dimension and a more totality of who you are. Again, did I say that right? This doorway pattern thing. Because that's what I wanted to really kind of get across tonight. We've talked a lot about harmony and balance. We've done a lot of practices. But again, some people hit balance. It's nice. And they stop there. I'm just saying, if you've got the time, the energy, or just strong pull that, no, there's more, then it's a doorway. Use it. Trade in whatever words you want to use there for the next dimension of who you are. Blah, blah, blah. Did I miss anything there? Talk to me.
Can I say it's from New Zealand? I was just going to say that I think that one of the elements that has to be there for this all to happen is you've got to be curious and inquisitive. And I don't know necessarily that everybody is, that for a lot of people, it's okay just to get so far.
No, they're comfortable in their normal life. Don't bother me. I don't want more shit I have to do. I ain't got time to meditate. I got my bowling class tonight or club. Yeah. So yeah. Of course.
And I also wonder if maybe that curiosity and inquisitiveness are maybe qualities of with the warrior spirit.
And warrior spirit, the priestly spirit, the psychological spirit. They each have their own view take on it. It's not just limited to one style. We can't ask everybody to be a warrior to do this. So since they happen to be a warrior, I happen to like the warrior line, but that's, you each have your own form. Okay. So we're not asking you to be umpteen don in Aikido. That's bullshit. You like music, you like social networking kind of thing and development. Beautiful, yeah. So let's not limit people is all I'm trying to say. Yeah. Did I miss anything in the basic harmony patterns, body movement, chanting, vibrational, if you're a musician, maybe basic meditation with some kind of two beat sense there? Did we cover most of the main ones? Did I miss any?
Sensei, it's Chip.
Chip. Hi, Chip. Go.
Harmony as a physical body sensation, that's been something that has been showing for me.
Okay. By the way, before you continue, what you said body, so you must be doing something body. What anything?
Is swimming.
Swimming, okay.
And so I can feel when there's harmony in the body, it has a particular sensation that all of a sudden just starts showing that there's, and that balance is there too. But I think for me, it comes is harmony as a physical sensation, as a healing sensation.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. And then we'd say, if you have the time in the pool and the interest, can you go another dimension?
Yeah, that's...
I know the pleasant feeling of the body being in harmony with itself at that level. It's very nice.
Right.
But what I'm trying to push tonight is now that's a doorway. Are you going to take advantage of the doorway? Do you want to take advantage of the doorway?
there's a feeling of connection with the space, because the space is water and the body is water. So there becomes a kind of... connection there too, so it can lead to
that's cute. See, right there, you're getting a good, say the body is the center and the water of the pool is the circle, that they're starting to say, hey, we're in agreement in that sense that we're both water. That's cute. That's cute. Yeah. Okay. Wanted to say something. I don't know if I think I mentioned maybe a couple of years ago, OSensei was taken by this guy in his fishing village who was an underwater spear fisherman. And OSensei liked to go in the water and go deep. And anyway, so he knows this guy from the village they're in. And this guy's very good with it. And something about when the guy was in the water, he looked like a fish. He moved like a fish. He wasn't just a comfortable swimmer. He had maybe gone past that level to where even his exterior movements and stuff begin to look like a fish. So could that be an example of one more inner level? Just an aside story, no big deal, but yeah. What if we do an old time, simple practice, but I think just for fun, okay? And I'll do it standing, yeah. Oh, okay. Check my camera over here. There he is. Okay. There are two forces, okay? In this case, simple one, a force that flows up through you and a force that flows down through you, okay? Easy. Settle, open. So first it's an idea. Fine, you got to start someplace. But then as we settle and open, energies flow up through, energies flow down through. Maybe the beginning of a little bit of feeling about those forces, not a continual knowing and get a better mental image of them. It's more internal as soon as you can, okay? So there's idea, there's feeling, there's finer feeling, there's sense feeling, okay? That's where we're heading to, whether we give you the time to hit that level, just the sense of that. One of those forces is masculine, one of those forces is feminine. I'll let your system, you, decide which is which, okay? For me, historically, masculine has been up, feminine down. That's just been me historically. You're you, whichever. So in allowing this force to flow through, touching the other one responds down, through. Deeper, one of them is male, one of them is female. One of them is female, one of them is male. Are we at that level yet, or is it too soon? Easy, settling, opening. Even. So the energies that flow are at a better dimensional level, they're finer, and they flow through. And rebound, the other one flows through. Down deeper, easy, more open. For lack of words, what should we say here? Listen. Sense, feel, or finer feeling, this energy, masculine or feminine, and this one, feminine or masculine. Brad, can you tell yet which? Is it too early in the game? Can you tell yet which is a he and which is a she?
I'm feeling down is more masculine and up is more feminine for me.
Okay. As you play with this and give it a few extra minutes, that would become clear, especially as you easy, settled feel, finer feeling, sense feeling. Okay. Now, easy, everything talks. So this energy that comes up says something about or to that other force. That other force responds, says something back. They're dialoguing. And you get to the level where you can hear, not physically with your ear, sense, feel, hear, experience what they're saying to each other. Okay. I'm taking the approach that we're not at a harmonious level yet. Taking the approach that at the level I'm at playing this game, they're still at odds a bit. She's not sure about he, and he thinks she's a bit. I'm at that level, okay? Following that pattern, what is one saying to the other? And how does the other retort? Brad, you got a conversation over there, a little with each other?
Yeah, right now I'm hearing, I feel the down masculine is like a call, and then the feminine is an answer. And
well, what's he calling? What's he saying to her? What's she saying to him?
He is saying to she, I'm here. Mm-hmm. And then she is, I'm feeling a sense of delay and a gap, but the she is saying, ready to receive. It's like they're still static, but at the level I'm at right now, but I feel there's a call and then there's.
I wanted it to be a little tighter. So they're still with each other, but he's not playing. He's gone past that. So we won't listen to him for now. He jumps past us.
Well, they're not talking to each other fully. So that's concentrating. Yeah.
So he's saying, I'm ready, and she's saying, I got something.
Yeah.
But they haven't fully, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the promise of, but it's not the fullness of the experience of, can we say it that way?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Now I'm getting a sense of, he's saying, I'm here, and the she's saying, well, so what? It's not quite,
Okay. So after a while, I think of it like the dating game. At first, they're not sure about each other. They're both kind of careful. One may be more okay, but the other one's hesitant. Something not harmonious. And as you hang more room, finer dimension, more rooms, they start to work it out, okay? And there should be a certain level where their relationship, we could call a harmonious center, harmonious, what word are we using? Balance. That there's a certain level of where they're more in accord with each other. And you can sort of softly feel it, sense feel it, inner imagine feel it, actually. Okay. So again, I ran it fast. But just to get you to remember, we did this practice. You can remember how they were bitching at each other at first and how they begin to work it out and get more okay with each other. Ah, that's a movement of the he, she energies, getting more in harmony. When they're in harmony, there's that centered balance, we're calling it. And that's a doorway, if you've got the time and energy and interest, to move into a much finer dimension. Who are you at that next finer dimension? Okay. Or we could even then a who are you, just when the two forces are more okay with each other, as if they're parents and they've bred you, the character. When they're more in harmony, feeling you, the character, because they're more in harmony, the character should be a bit better, no? Kind of thing? Yeah. Anyway, that's the practice. We don't have time really to do it its full length of time that we need, but Justin, that's all I was trying to say at the beginning. When you're using your partner as a reference, I said, yeah, that's great. I also like this very personal. That's a very personal practice. Okay. It's just me with the two forces of me. Okay.
Yes, I jumped ahead there a little bit. Sorry, I jumped the gun.
Kind of short, but did we get... Tell me about your conversation of he to she to he. Anybody get to the point where they could hear the conversation?
Sensei, Bob here.
Go for it.
She was offering love and support, and he was offering intelligence and strength. It took a while to get there.
What was the bitch? Go back heavier. Tell me about the bitch before they work this out.
Yeah, I was just about to do that.
Thank you. Okay. Go.
She was offering, and he was going, I don't know about this. I'm not sure I understand what you're offering. I don't know if I want it. Maybe there's strings attached, et cetera, et cetera. So it was a big question mark. On the male side, as far as what the female was offering. And that caused some consternation on her part because her offering wasn't
responding. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that was the then that part.
Yeah. Okay. So when they come to terms, continue, Bob, when they come to terms and they're whatever she's offering and whatever his relation back is, there's a certain point there that we're using the word balance point. Okay. And at the balance point, we could play different games. At the balance point, we could say, okay, your parents, if we look at them as parents, for example, your parents are more in accord. You heard what they were offering each other. Now they bred you, the character. Who are you? Feel yourself, experience yourself, you. So you could do it at that level, okay? Before we use the doorway approach to a finer level, you could establish you at you character at that level. Okay, am I saying it right, clearly? Yeah? Somebody, anything out of this? Did you hear the conversation all right?
Sensei, it's Justin again. For me, the male component was a very active, energetic, let's go component. And the feminine was a more form, framework, logistics, support oriented.
Back a little tighter for me. What was their bitch at first?
So So it seemed like he was excited to go on a picnic and very spontaneous and let's go. It's so much fun. Let's have a picnic. And she said, whoa, whoa, whoa. What about the gas in the car? Do you have the map? You know, let's make lunch first. You know, let's put some structure into this. Love the idea, but we're not ready to just head out the door yet.
Yeah.
Reservation was coming up, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. Then we move on. Let's see. They move on to some harmony. Did you express that clear enough yet? The harmony between them, yeah. And there, if you were to check you, the character, with those as parents, let's say, feeling you, character, tell me about you. It's the child born out of harmonious parents at this level. Tell me about you.
Is a child that has a sense of balance when it comes to working with both the flow and the form of a situation, or the framework and the energy required. There's a balanced way that they come together and they agree. Right. They agree. Too spontaneous is much. And we can't plan forever either. There's a happy medium.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. So a balance between the energy and the framework of a situation. Yeah. Both.
And again, for people, now he knows this. He knows this. I would want to double check myself. The feeling of me character. Mm-hmm. Okay. We're getting, let's see, mom is good at that and dad is good at that. Therefore, it should be this. It's fine. But we got to be careful. We're not just doing idea awareness all the time. The experience, the character that breathes, that flexes, that's something, boom. The character. His sense of what he can do. Mm-hmm. And make sure we get a lot of that, the experience of. See, I'm always fighting against the awareness of, and the awareness people unfortunately think they've got it all. In fact, that's another good way of looking at this. The awareness people can expand through awareness and think they got it all, and they miss the experiential. They miss the experiential. Okay, and that's very critical that we get this fullness. Okay. All right. So in the human condition, we have a preponderance for awareness and not anywhere near enough experience. And that continues on through even finer dimensions. So don't let up on it. As you develop finer dimensionally, keep checking on that experiential. Double check it, because the awareness will be aware of the word experience and say, oh yes, I'm experiencing. And I get the feeling that they're close, but it's not the experience. Okay. That's why I bring up the dumb stories of getting close to the hot bathtub. And you get close, you feel the steam, you feel the moisture, you feel the heat. And you know about a hot bathtub. You got a lot of knowledge about it. Say, oh, I'm experiencing. And I say, no, not in this way. In this way, you got to sort of immerse totally in the tub, feeling the heat. Okay. And doing what Chip was saying with swimming, where the hotness of the tub and the warmness of the body are like one thing. Okay. About that. Anyway, just a reminder. Somebody help. Say something intelligent here. Say something not so intelligent. I don't care. Say something.
Sensei, Teresa here.
Hey, Teresa there.
So I have a question. In regards to when you're in that balance space and you feel that you are balanced, and then as far as walking through that doorway, or is that like a thought saying I'm walking through the doorway because I feel balanced, or what does that?
Well, okay. It's not a thought. Okay. Mm-hmm. I might have a thought before that. Oh, this is a nice balanced place. Oh, that's right. There's a doorway here. Easy. A sense feeling, not physical feeling, an inner sense, interdimensional, inner sense of moving out of the realm you're in into a finer realm. It's not just an idea. We need more experience. So the sense of, how to say it better? Somebody, we got a lot of smart people out there. How would you say that better? What I'm not saying well yet. Somebody?
Sean here. I would say that, you know, sometimes you notice that there's a predisposition to a tendency. And then you break through, and there's an immersion into that, the actual situation.
Okay.
And that.
Hold it there. I like the word immersion, inner sense, a finer dimension, sensing. I can't really do a proper immersion with an idea. I can have an idea of immersion, but I'm not immersing.
Yes. No. Yes. Completely submersed in the actual experience.
Yeah. That diagram ain't bad.
And then noticing that there's a proclivity, a tendency, a history of a something else, and that's being real. There's an honesty factor. There's what do you want to call it? I mean, like God forbid, the day when you're not around, to like talk in my ear and say, hey, wake up. You know, this is different. You know, this is now. And that's the, so like noticing my own proclivities.
Yeah.
Noticing my own tendencies.
Okay. I like the one thing there you brought up where I'm the nag in the ear. Hey, wake up. When I'm gone.
Okay. Yeah.
What I'm hoping is that we open enough, we settle enough, and that we know the main pieces there, and we open to them. So yourself may say, hey, you're being this, and I'm self, and I'm here. Come on back to the more of me, okay? Or it could be the energy, the aliveness, which we have to lay out on a Friday night class. The underlying energy, vitality, OSensei like that word, the original all ki. Okay. And that can be a spark where that will push and prod and move you around. So to have the ability of listening within yourself for guidance would be nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Sensei, you have shown me more than a few times the urgency of nowness with the abruptness that a martial art requires. And that is, essential to the martial arts, the Budo, and it is, I feel, your essential quality that I feel as a student very fortunate to have witnessed or to have experienced.
I think
urgency is the main point.
I think, Brett, I think it's a matter, my bitch on things would be, who did it? It's urgent. Perfect. easy, settle. There is a level where if it happens to be now, it's now. And that wasn't my best level. Easy, settle, another level. Easy, easy. That moves, this moves. So, see, it depends who did the urgency. If you're doing the urgency, then no, man, no. If it comes from an inner finer, and it's just an inner finer thing, that's different. Okay. Now you have to have a sense of the inner sense of things as opposed to the outer sense of things. Mm-hmm. Anyway, blah, blah. But let's go back. Somebody, let's go back to a simple statement to Teresa about inner sense. Remember her question? Inner sense. Somebody have a easy form? Noah, you're not going to bite the bait on that one?
Yes, that's it's the same pattern again. You stay present, you stay open. And
okay, hold it there a moment. I'm just jumping on words. You can't say the same pattern to Teresa because this is her second show. She hasn't memorized all the patterns or practiced all the patterns. So let's talk to Teresa.
Once you get to that state of balance, if you stay open, if you stay present, and you have the interest, as you were saying, to move on, that's enough. And if you hold that place, what's next will begin to show itself on its own terms. It's okay. Not something you have to know in advance or decide what it might be. It will show itself.
Okay, but I don't want them to hold at the balance point. You see, because that's a problem already in a lot of cases. Well, I'll wait for God to tell me what to do or something. You're an inquirer. You're a seeker for finer. So can't you at least there say, if there's more, please show. Easy. I'm trying to be here as best as I can. Easy settling. Show yourself. I hear there's a next finer here. Easy. Are you there? Easy. Open. Listen. Feel. Sense. So a little more activity than just...
Most definitely, you can do what you just said.
Yeah.
Without pre-forming or cutting it off.
Yeah. Yeah.
The danger is in predetermining what it might be.
Ah. Oh, yes.
The way you just said it, you wouldn't do that.
Yeah. All I know is it's there and there is more. And the more may show as more space. The more may show as a better level character. The more may show as a clearer shot on the design of creation, how the forces work. Okay. Or the self. Easy the eye. Eventually there is a self there. Okay. But I know using any one of those, whichever feels comfortable for me at that time, or whichever one I want to major in, we could say, that there is something. And I settle open for it. Blah, blah. And it wants to show. It's not hiding the finer of things. Seems like it sometimes. Like, where the hell is God when you need him, kind of thing. You know, we're putting up the obstruction, let's say. Easy. Easy. Letting go of everything. Let that that's there show. Let that that's there be present. Easy. Sense finer. Sense finer. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. Anyone on Teresa's what do you do at the doorway question, I believe is what she asked. Nobody's going to jump on that. Dear God, people. I thought I had a semi-advanced group here.
Okay. I'll try a little bit, Bob.
Thank you.
But what it takes me to is very early on working with you, and, you know, we did some processing and meditation and all that, and my life got better. I mean, you know, I was not constantly nagged by that chattering conscious mind. And I remember at some point along the way, you, and I don't know how you said it, but was that that's all well and good, but, and I suppose that's the hammock. You know, you get to that place and you think, oh, you know, this is very cool. I like what we're doing and I feel better in my life. But then you start talking about, and you continually would say, there's more. You would, that's a constant theme of yours. There's more. And what else? And I think we have to come up against our own tendency to just want to feel good. And we get to that place of balance or harmony. But the next thing is going to show itself. It's that portal that you're suggesting. And I think we have to be able to separate, you know, that immediate feeling, which is nice, with that sense that, okay, and what's next? That portal. We're always standing at the doorway. I don't think there's ever a time that we're not at the doorway to what's next.
So, and all we're saying is be proper at the doorway by using the harmony game, whatever form you like harmony. You're going to chant it, sit it, move it, whatever. Boom. So you're proper at the doorway.
Yeah. Yeah. And being ready and open to something more. So, and that's the, to me, that's the portal, is that it's almost like an attitude. You're saying, okay, yes. And being open to that.
Yeah. Yeah. And just, it's, I think, difficult, Teresa, it's not thinking, but there may be a thought that precedes here. What should I do now? Okay, that's a thought. Easy. As we settle and open, one pattern I use is thinking, feeling, finer feeling, inner sensing. This inner world, that's where we're going for this inner world, and being, letting it do whatever. For example, it mixes up a finer level character. You're a calmer character. You can move in such a way that you couldn't have moved before. Just as an example, your self's viewpoint. What's your philosophy? What's your viewpoint of life at this level? And hopefully the eye doesn't jump in and take it over again. It's a self sense. I don't know how, but I believe there's some hope in the world. I hope I'm right. We'll see at the level I'm at. Whatever. So we've got four main components that we can use in our settling, opening, to reference our presence in the next level. But you can't just think about the next level. That's why I did the diagram. Thinking, feeling, finer feeling, much finer feeling, sense feeling, sensing is a dialogue for this inner realm. Don't know how to say it any better.
You know, another thing, you know, you give us a lot of information. I mean, we're learning, you know, there's a lot of depth to what we're talking about. And we have to hold that, you know, like, for instance, even the thinking, feeling, sense feeling, sensing. That's information in a way.
At that level, yes. I gave you information up here. Now it's up to you to experience that.
Yeah, you can't hold on to the information. Yeah. You kind of have to be really easy with that.
Yeah, it's a starting place. Yes. Now he said finer feeling. Okay, let me, I'm feeling. Now easy, settle, open, finer feeling. And there's just something going on. It feels like a finer feeling. Okay, easy, easy, settle, open. And again, this is an inward journey. I'm not out here. Okay, it's an inward journey. Easy. A finer, finer feeling. Interesting. At this level, I don't move my arms. It's like being moved. It's like there's something happening that they're floating them up, kind of thing. I'm starting to get some inner experience of something. Blah, 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 blah. The words are bitchy, people. Do the best you can. Let's see. I want to do a quick aside for a moment. Yeah, forget it. Anything? We're a quarter of already. Teresa, are you still on? Or did you give up in disgust?
No, I'm still here.
What would you consider meditating? What is meditation to you?
Well, currently my practice is quiet, emptying my mind, focusing on breath. And then depending on if I'm working on something, like if it's a painting or something, I might just see like if something surfaces and then go from there with it.
Oh, okay. In that case, I don't think Tija and myself would call that meditation if you're settling in whatever to be more, to do a better painting or work out a better paint plan. Or...
Yeah, I'm not talking about like an intention. Like if I'm going to be painting and have an intention, I'm going and breathing and clearing thought. Sometimes things
to get at appear. A better level of artist. Could I say that?
Yeah.
And that's okay. That's okay. It's common sense. If you're going to hit the golf ball, settle and open, get to a better level so the golf ball gets hit better. Yeah, that's daily common usage. It'd be nice if every human knew that because they'd function better and they'd feel better and be better. Yes. But it's not what us deep people are saying is meditation. Meditation, we want to get out of that whole realm even into a finer level. And then we'll see how the finer level does things. But to go a little more into the finer dimensional, and if I just go into a calmer place where I can more calmly decide on what to paint or whatever, or how to hit the golf ball, whatever. But we go more and more and more, finer and finer and finer. Could we distinguish it that way? So what you did for your process is like, yes. Now let's continue finer and finer, just for this inquiry's sake. Could I say it that way? Just to see what's there and finer and finer, see what shows there and finer and finer. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this last week, some girls and I, we've been doing like this dance group, but it's been calling me more and more and more to do it. But it's coming from within, and it's... Okay. But so when you were talking about balance, that resonated with me because I'm so good at dancing, but I feel like I could be better. So that was when you said that, that really, I was cool. Like, okay, well, then maybe I'm at that gateway place.
That's good. People, What she's saying is her sense of the push she's getting from is an inner push. That's cool. Okay? It's an inner push. It wasn't like your parents saying, you should go to more dance classes, or your best friend saying, go to more dance classes. And it's like, nah, I don't want to. It's this inner push. You're feeling this desire. So that's an inner push. Okay? And I like to follow inner pushes because it's an aspect of me that wants to develop more. So you think your dance skills are pretty good, but your inner character, inner self, somebody, your inner energy, somebody in there is saying, you'll get more now. Go back. There's more for you here. And we'll develop that aspect of you by going back to more involvement in dance. So, yeah. Did I say that right? Damn the words.
So in that place, though, so is that something where I'm getting quiet with it before? Or if I'm out, because we're out in the park dancing, and then that's when I'm getting that feeling for like more. And so like
another dimensional level of dancing.
Yeah.
I've laid that out as Bobby Robert Nadeau. So Bobby has to trade in for Robert. And as soon as possible, Robert trades in for Nadeau. Nadeau trades in for the great sensei. Yeah. It's just saying, using this form, it's saying to you, come into your next dimension here, this inner dimension, and it'll be a better dancer. And then at that level, you'll experience or learn things. You'll experience things that are beneficial for you. I don't know what they are. It's your system. You'll experience. Okay?
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Yes. Yeah. Thank you.
Basic people don't understand the push of things. And in the human condition, often the push is received as a negative. Oh, I'm getting antsy. Oh, this makes me nervous. Oh, that's annoying me. But if we hang and settle and open and say, hey, I played the say what game. What'd you really say? You didn't say annoy me. What'd you really say? Easy. What'd you really say? Or what are you really trying to do? I don't think you're trying to annoy me. You have my attention. Here I am. Say what? What are you presenting? What should I soak in? What should I inhale, so to speak? Inner sense. Yeah. So even that first part where people are being pushed in some form, either the I pushes, because you're being a cell, you're being an identity, and the I will go, come on, move along, come back to me. Or it may be just the energy. There's an underlying energy for everything. Okay. And it'll push. Easy. We'll do a Friday night and just highlight the energy things. So energy advanced presentation. And we'll do that soon. I've got it sort of roughly in my notes to follow up on. Autumn, you on?
Hi, Sensei.
I don't see your face. Where are you? Can I see your face? Or are you? There you are. Hi. File this one away because I'm wondering if a missing piece or a missing something for you is this inner aliveness, this juiciness, this core power, let's call it. Let's use human terms, this core power. That if we don't have that enough or know how it works, we could have a sense of things, sort of a shadow outline of ourselves and a shadow outline of ourselves as a famous actress or whatever. But it's a sort of a shadow outline. It's sort of hollow a bit, and you kind of feel hollow. Yes, I sort of believe it. I sort of trust it, but, and you ain't got the guts for it. So I'm thinking about, and I'll double check with the energy aspect, but I'm thinking a lot of people don't really utilize this enough or know quite how it works, or they stop short. They get a little, Katya, what is it you do, Pilates? They get some degree of core, and they think, that's it, I've got core. Hell, that's just the beginning, people. Or the Tai Chi master, whoa, he's fancy. He does things that are like, whoa, we're not finished. There's more. There's a whole original of energy. Anyway, so I want to do a whole Friday night on just the energy. I just thought I'd give you a heads up on. I'm wondering if you don't need a little more of that. Boom. Oh, since they might call it inner fire. Okay, we'll find whatever words you like. That's different names. Just have the feeling that just a feeling that you could use it. It would make things easier. Because the shadow sense of ourselves, what a bitch. I got a good vision of it. You know, I believe it. I really feel that, whatever. But there's a little but in there, but I don't know what to do or whatever. I think it's this energy part that we haven't clarified enough. Okay. Anyway, another Friday night for that. We're reaching the end already. And anything to finish up here? Is that sort of okay? Harmony, different forms of harmony. So in this case, I'm just trying to show there's a center of the circle, a pattern, character to the situation he's in, or this up and down, high things, real deep things. We could also use that as you have the idea, good. Now give me the experience. They'll be equal to it. So they're in harmony. And because of the harmony, there'll be a character, there'll be a better level of self, there'll be more sense of the space of things, there'll be a better sense of the, what's our word?
Portal.
Construct, no, construct. I'm going for the four. Didn't you catch I was going for the four? Who was that?
Space, character, design. Self, design.
Design of the creation, yeah. Oh, okay. You got one last minute. Then I'm out of here. Anything? One last minute. Observation, insight. You want to vomit? Go ahead.
Well, Sensei, this is Lauren. I think that it's actually quite, fascinating what you've done tonight, because you've taken two giant themes that you've worked on through these lectures for each one of them for months. The center circle dynamic that you had there on the left and the awareness experience dynamic. And what you've said tonight is that you can approach this, if you like, as center circle. And you talk to us about, well, some people are more center and some people are more circle, and you should take, follow your tendency, but then try the other to get balance.
Yeah.
And you've also said, well, many people start with up in their head and they have an idea about energy, but that's not really the energy. They have to experience it. And as they open and settle, they'll experience it more, and then they have a better idea of it, and it goes round and round and builds on itself. And what you're saying tonight is that either way, either approach to this sense of balance,
yeah,
harmony, let's say completeness, that, you can take your circle and rotate it however many times you want.
People, you've got your own styles. We just give you some main examples. But whatever's comfortable for you, that, I don't know what to say, fits in with the construct design of creation. Okay, certain basics from very fine, tighter and tighter and tighter into heavier. Here we are. And from heavier to finer, 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 finer. That beat is a part of the design, a very important part of the design. That's why you could be pretty good and then be pushed into bitchier and bitchier. Where did that come from? Well, that's the forces working. But those same forces go the other way, and they can help you settle and open and return back to the more of yourself. So you learn to recognize, be present properly in the force beat, the design of creation. Just simplify things.
Well, you've simplified things a lot tonight. Thank you so much.
Great, great. I'm happy. Thank
you, Sensei, and good night. Good night, everyone.
Take care.
Thank you, Sensei.
Hey, Tom, good to see you there.
Thanks, Sensei. Thanks, Sensei.
See you, everybody.
Thanks, Sensei.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
Everything the best to you and everyone still out there, Lauren.
Thank you, Mike.